That is our own Six Strings Stew swinging away down there in the Gate City. But there'll be no Gate City review today on the iWeb Radio Network because Stu's got a computer problem there that he's going to get fixed, or it's on loan or something. So look for Stu to be back next week on the Gate City Review at 6 o'clock right here on the iWeb Radio Network. We're broadcasting on two different networks today, by the way, gang. The iWeb Radio Network and on Live 365. And we're broadcasting live of no less on Saturday, March 29th, 2014. And we're talking about the potential inductees. Who would you like to see inducted into the Country Music Hall of Fame this year? They haven't been announced yet, to my knowledge, but we're expecting it any day. We are expecting it any day, so get your requests and suggestions up there. Let me know. Put them in the chat room or send me email on who you think should be inducted into the Country Music Hall of Fame. Okay, how about that? As we mentioned, Tom Steiner is listening. Nice to have you on board, Tom, after a very difficult month or two, I'm sure. And according to your emails that you sent me, your mom was a big Freddie Fender fan. She loved Freddie Fender along with probably country music in general. Well, here's Freddie Fender for Tom's mom. This is, I think, his biggest hit. This put Freddie Fender on the charts.
If he brings you happiness, then I wish you both the best. It's your happiness that matters most of all. But if he ever breaks your heart, if the teardrop ever starts, I'll be there before the next teardrop falls. Si te quiere de verdad y te da felicidad, te deseo lo más bueno para los dos. Pero si te hace llorar, a mí me puedes hablar. Y estaré contigo cuando triste estás. I'll be there anytime you need me by your side to drive away every teardrop that you cry. And if he ever leaves you blue, just remember I love you. And I'll be there before the next teardrop falls. And I'll be there before the next teardrop falls.
Well, look who's coming through the door. I think we've met somewhere before. Hello, love. Hello, love. Where in the world have you been so long? I missed you so since you've been gone. Hello, love. Hello, love. Make yourself feel right at home. I hope you plan on staying long. Come in, love. Come in, love. must say I was sure surprised. You're the last thing I expected by Helula. Helula. I've heard it said time and again, you often go back where you've been. I really didn't believe it was true, but I left the door unlocked for you. I'll try to please you in every way, assure you of a pleasant stay this time, love. This time, love. I've been so blue since you've been gone. Now you're back with me and nothing's wrong. Hello, love. Hello, love. Heard it said time and again, you often go back where you've been. I really didn't believe it was true, but I left the door unlocked for you. It's wonderful now you're back with me, and things are like they used to be. Remember, love. Remember, love. You're back with me and my world's complete. So don't mind me if I repeat, hello, love. Hello, love. Hello, love.
Hank Snow, hello, love. Ah, here we go. Hank Snow for Frances, Tom's late mom there. She loved Hank Snow, I'm sure, Tom. Thanks, Tom. We appreciate it. And Tom, you want to hang on because coming up in just a few minutes, about 10 minutes or so after I get done reading some stuff here, we're going to have one by Canada's singing cowboy, Wilf Carter. You were the first person who emailed me and told me about Wilf Carter. And as I mentioned on our show 2 weeks, I think it was 2 weeks ago, I found a source for some Wilf Carter music, and we're going to be adding him. This is the second or third one we've added to our playlist, so you'll hear more Wilf Carter in the future. Canada's singing cowboy. And Lad said 2 weeks ago, he says, Dave, it's about time you played some Wilf Carter music. So I remember that. That's up on our podcast page. We just put the last three shows up on our podcast page, pioneersofcountry.com. The last three live ones, so you can listen to them replay whenever you have time. We haven't had a chance to put them up on a timely basis because we ran out of space, so I had to do some manipulating of the server and space there. So we're able to do that, and today's show hopefully will get up there a lot sooner than we have. As I was said earlier, this is the time of the year when the Country Music Association announces their inductees to the Country Music Hall of Fame, and each year it stretched further and further. Last year it was April 10th, I think, when it was announced, so the sooner the better. The rules: Country Music Hall of Fame inductees are selected through a committee process appointed by the CMA. Since 2010, the selection process has been split up into three categories: the modern era, the veterans era, and a non-performer songwriter. So this year, potential, these aren't dyed in the wool, but the scuttlebutt going around the country music industry is that there's some pretty good possibilities of folks that are going to be inducted into the Country Music Hall of Fame this year. In the modern era inductees, these are the ones that I think have performed in the last 20 years or so. Ricky Skaggs, he's a possibility, an artist that felt like he's been right on the bubble of being inducted over the last couple of years. He has bookended his career as a mandolin maestro, studied under Bill Monroe, and is now firmly ensconcing himself as a country music elder. So another one possibly is Ronnie Millsap. Ronnie Millsap is going to be performing tonight on the Grand Ole Opry, live from Nashville, Tennessee, on March 29th. Tune in if you want. Millsap is his name has probably been on the final ballots for the Hall of Fame for going on 2 decades. And a couple of years will cycle over to a veterans era. That's where the veterans era is performers that have been performing or have performed more than 40 years, for more than 40 years. And he had a lot of commercial success is unquestionable. And the fact that he started outside the genre and found a lot of his success as a crossover star might make him a hard name for voters to pull the trigger on. Having said that, seeing another name who started outside of country, had a lot of success in the crossover world, got inducted last year, Kenny Rogers. So, Ronnie Millsap, one step closer. We hope Ronnie gets in. He's one of our favorite singers, Ronnie Millsap. So, pray for him. Alan Jackson, he's another one. 2013 was Jackson's first year of eligibility, and there was a sense that he just missed out on being a first-year modern era inductee like Garth Brooks and Reba McEntire were a few years ago. Alan Jackson's possibly. Randy Travis, at this time of the year, despite Randy's fresh eligibility and unquestionable credentials for the Hall of Fame, he was facing a string of drunk driving charges at this time last year and spinning the unsavory story of trying to bum a cigarette at a gas station naked. In such a crowded field, it is easy to give Travis a pass. But this year, the story is much different. After suffering from a heart condition and stroke, while in the midst of a strong recovery from his personal issues, Randy Travis has to be considered the sympathy favorite for this distinction. Will it be enough? Maybe, maybe not. But Randy will be the front runner in the modern era until he is inducted. That's for, and we hope he gets in there. He's done so good, and we just don't know if he's ever going to perform again. There was a picture of Randy, his first public appearance since his stroke. And he came out, I think, to see a country performer sing. And I have a picture of that. I think what I'll do is I'll post that today on the podcast page. When I post this show, you'll see a picture of Randy Travis's first public appearance since his stroke. So he's out and about, and he's going to therapy on a regular basis. And we certainly hope, wish him well, and hopefully he can recover and once again entertain us with great country music. Brooks and Dunn, a commercial powerhouse whose career was somewhat overshadowed by the success of Garth Brooks, and their strange place as a non-country duo. In their first non-family country duo, their first album, Brand New Man, sold over 6 million copies, so they're a possibility this year. I don't know. What do you think, huh? David Allan Coe is in that crowd. I suppose much to ask to see David Allan Coe, since there's six strings too. Well, you don't know. It's possible. Those are some of the contenders. I'm reading this. I gleaned this off the internet, so it's not something that I'm writing. I don't want to plagiarize anybody or whatever, but I printed this out from the internet, and I would give credit if I had it, but whoever it is, I give credit to who wrote this. This is awesome. Other possible modern era inductees to the Country Music Hall of Fame, and these are people that I've had at least 20 years, I think, in performing. The Oak Ridge Boys, The Judds, Dwight Yoakam, Keith Whitley, Clint Black, Toby Keith, Charlie Daniels, Tanya Tucker, Crystal Gayle, Gene Watson, Mickey Gilley. Wow. That's a strong, a lot of contenders there that aren't in the Country Music Hall of Fame. And that's just the modern era inductees. In a few minutes, we'll talk about the veterans era inductees. These are folks that I believe have performed for more than 40 years in country music. So it's a pretty good, interesting thing there. Country music, they don't, they're kind of, make sure that these people are worth it. There's other halls of fame that just induct anybody, folks you've never even heard of, and I'm not going to go into details about that, the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, but let's not go there, okay? 16 minutes after.